Restaurant quality meals to your kitchen with my fish dish. Found and appreciated by your local Hattiesburg. My self-regulating leadership coach, helping businesses and individuals say it simply, clearly, and persuasively. Yeah. Learn more at
SethRigoletti.com. And my mechanical
services,
committed to providing main healthcare
facilities with reliable HVAC systems, building controls, and
service. Excuse my language.
And take a quick look at the weather tonight. Snow will be ending in the northern and eastern parts of the state. We'll have some light rain in the south tonight after midnight. That might get a little icy tomorrow morning. Temperatures in the 20s and 30s. Tomorrow for Thanksgiving, it'll be overcast with some rain around midday.
Maybe a little bit of fog.
35 in the north and 46 along the coast. And on Friday, it should be partly sunny and a lot warmer. Nice 47 in the north, 50s in the south.
We're pretty hosting here.
Wonders. But then, as the kindergarten teacher was preparing for a virtual parent-teacher conference,
I think if it had been any other year, my panic level probably would have been a lot higher. Honestly, I was like, well, of course there's a cyber attack.
She and other teachers are shut out of their grading portals, email, and even their phones.
I don't know how we're going to navigate this. My hope is that we will be able to get back into our virtual world as soon as possible.
Imagine if thieves snuck into school headquarters, loaded up every single document, and then put those files in a warehouse only they can enter. That's how ransomware works. It encrypts systems, and only the hackers have the key. Bobby Rubin is a computer science professor at Johns Hopkins University. He says, while it's too early to say for certain, the attacks look serious.
I don't think it's completely out of the question that we may not be able to finish out this year if we can't get back online in the next several weeks.
Schools are not traditional ransomware targets, but as many remain online, Rubin says hackers have more opportunities to infiltrate them.
Everybody is now using either Zoom or Microsoft Teams or some form of remote communication, and that includes students learning in school.
There's been at least 30 ransomware attacks on schools this year. This one has left more than 115,000 children who can't enter their classrooms due to the pandemic without a way to learn. Lamaki says she can't believe she's nostalgic for virtual learning.
We get excited to see each other every day, and even though we're seeing each other virtually, when one student is absent, they ask, why aren't they on the screen? Or they send virtual hugs to each other.
Baltimore County school officials say they're working with the FBI and they don't plan on paying ransom. For NPR News, I'm Emily.
See how full the. Oh, yeah, never mind. It's 8 hours.
And songwriter Suni Hawks is an unsung hero of the folk music
world.
For half a century, she's performed socially conscious music and traditional children's songs in Spanish. This year, the National Endowment for the Arts named her one of its Heritage Fellows, thus the most prestigious award for folk and traditional artists. And Pierre's Mandalito Barco shares her story. After moving from Argentina to the U.S. in 1967, Elsa Calendrell gave herself a stage name in Quechua, the indigenous language of the Andes.
I chose my Quechua name, Sunipaz, meaning lasting peace, because that's what I want.
The 85-year-old is dedicated to singing for and about indigenous and working class people and children of all backgrounds.
She never thought of her music as protest music. She thought of her music as something much deeper, much broader, much more profound.
Danielle Sheehy is the director of Smithsonian Folkways Recordings, which has released most of Paz's albums. He says she became associated with a new style of music from Latin America. He puts her in the same category as the great South American singers Violeta Parra and Mercedes Sosa.
She came along and did her thing before the term Nueva